I am Silvia Hernandez. I'm a partner at Ernst & Young, based in Stuttgart. I'm responsible for our Future of Work Now thinking, which is essentially the methodology that we use to help our organizations work through this digital transformation. I was born in Spain, and my mom was born during the Franco regime. And you may know that there was a very specific set of, you know, expectations for women and the role that women would have in society. So my mom would bring me to bed every night and say, you know, whatever you do, be independent. So I think, you know, if I can speak about something that has influenced me in terms of what I wanted to do, I just wanted to be independent and pursue my interests. That's been a very important message or a very important theme in how I think about what I do. I've been very privileged in that I've had a lot of sponsors in my career. Returning from maternity leave the last time was particularly difficult because the world moves on, the organization moves on, and I was only gone for, you know, just 6 months. But I think, you know, finding our sponsor, and as women, we speak about ourselves in a different level of language. We need to articulate, you know, the value of what we do, I think, more clearly. So I think that, you know, there's a lot of subjective bias that influences how we make decisions about who we want to be there next. And, you know, I work in Germany, which is not, you know, very diverse in terms of, you know, gender diversity at positions of management. Challenging our expectations about what good looks like and creating a space for that diversity to take place and for women to dare to say, I want to do this, right? I think we're always pushing back and saying, oh, I can't do this now because. I think we just need to find a space where we find the courage, or help them find the courage to articulate what they want to do. And I've been fortunate because I've had sponsors that have helped me do that, but I still find it really difficult sometimes. At EY, we do a lot of things around, you know, closing the pay parity gap, promoting, you know, girls in tech. We have an initiative in Germany that is been very successful. If you think about the evolution of work and a lot of the technological developments that we're seeing, we're risking that gender diversity gap becomes greater if we don't encourage young girls to go into math and tech and other things. So I think as a society, how do we think about role models, and how do we encourage young girls to think about what they can do in a way that embraces, you know, all of their capability? Yeah. So I think that this, you know, this idea that, you know, certain professions are gender suitable is something that we need to constantly challenge because it's very embedded in our society. Resilience is fundamental, you know, being, you know, capable of, you know, picking up where we've fallen and carry on. I think our ability to be authentic, I think we tend to imitate role models we have around it, and I don't think that that's appropriate. I think we need to be ourselves, and I think we need to be able to embrace what we don't understand and look for people that make us uncomfortable, you know, these people that challenge us and make it hard for us to articulate our thoughts. I think that that's really key in us breaking through some of these stereotypes, if you want.